from the prison walls of Rome in about 62 AD, we had this supremely blessed word, rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say rejoice. Glory, rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say rejoice. These were the words of a Roman prisoner, the Apostle Paul, to those who were free in the Philippian city of Eastern Macedonia. Brothers and sisters, the true freedom is the freedom of the soul. Welcome to our life lesson series, Immortal Voices, featuring 21 incredible stories from around the world and their immortal lessons. Today we are speaking on heavenly stores, drawing immortal lessons from the life of Madame Guyon, a woman persecuted and imprisoned both by the church and the government for loving Christ too much. The soul that loves God finds him everywhere, said Madame Guyon. This is absolutely beautiful, friends. The soul that loves God finds him everywhere. Yes, for the soul that loves God, you will find him in your heart. You will find him in your home. You will find him in your marriage. You will find him in your career. You will find him in your local church assembly, irrespective. You will find him on the streets. You will find him in open markets, in the classrooms, on your job desk. You will find him everywhere. The soul that loves God find him everywhere. Glory to God. The future is as bright as the promises of God. Oh, such a beautiful world. The future is as bright as the promises of God, meaning your future. My future is as bright as the promises of God. Glory to our God. Amen. This words again came out of the prison house in Buma over 200 years ago. Adoniram Judson was the first recorded American missionary to travel overseas to Buma, modern-day Myanmar. Judson, while serving a horrifying time in a Burmese jail of 19th century, could still lift up his voice with glowing confidence to declare within the prison walls, the future is as bright as the promises of God. Mr. Judson, in the midst of his Burmese prison horrors, took refuge in the walls of Madame Guyon when in prison herself. And Judson often used to murmur her beautiful lines for strength to his soul while in his own prison. No place I seek but to fulfill in life and death your lovely will. No succor in my woes I want, except what you are pleased to grant. Our days are numbered. Let us spare our anxious heart a needless care. It is yours to number out our days, and ours to give them to your praise. Citation of Madame Guyon. Such is the power and influence of Madame Guyon's life that has influenced believers over 300 years on. So much heaven in Guyon's heart. She died 9 June 1717, age 69, but she lives on. John Wesley said of Guyon, "You can search 1,000 centuries before you find a woman in the class of Guyon's holiness." This is amazing. 1,000 centuries is 100 years in 1,000 places. That's 100,000 years reference by Wesley. Whereas our earth is only about 6,000 years old, Guyon was deeply outstanding. One commentator said, only two people have fully lived the life of Christ. One is the Apostle Paul. The second is Madame Guyon. Taking too far? Well, permit it. Sometimes we just lack powerful words to really express our hearts. Our hearts are stronger than vocabularies. The power of expression in a single heart is stronger than all the languages of the world put together. Wesley L. Duell, author of A Blaze for God, said Madame Guyon experienced a near mystical union of her will with the will of God. Even to really spiritual giants, Guyon's depth was and is a mystery. Jean Mary Bovire de la Motte, Guyon, commonly known as Madame Guyon, was born 13 April 1648 to a wealthy noble family in France. She wanted to be a nun, but against her will was married off into a wretched marriage by her father at age 16 to a wealthy gentleman, Jacques Guyon, who was 22 years her senior. Mr. Guyon intensely persecuted his wife, at a point setting their son as a spy to report whenever their mother had prayer devotion, so as to unleash more persecution by a combined team of husband, mother-in-law and housemaid. Even her own housemaid was empowered to oppress her. During her 12 years of marriage, Guyon suffered terribly at the hands of her mother-in-law and housemaid. Adding to her misery were the deaths of her half-sister, followed by her mother and her son. Her daughter and father then died within days of each other in July 1672. She lost two of her five children. 4 years later, her husband died and she became a widow at the age of 28. Madame Guyon was then free to leave and she never remarried. Her times of massive oppression in marriage led her to deep withdrawals into the prayer life, where she abundantly found God in a flood of joy, as she wrote on 22 July 1680. All I had enjoyed before was only a peace, a gift of God, but now I receive and possess the God of peace. She was an apostle of the secrets of deeper spiritual life that she had found. She became influential at the French court. Her disciples in the palace lived lives of such purity that they stood out in contrast to the greed and sexual debauchery of the majority. In an era when both the official church and government were massively corrupt, they found Madame Guyon's life and writings about the deeper inner spiritual life offensive. She was imprisoned from 1695 to 1703 after publishing a book on the topic, A Short and Easy Method of Prayer. Imprisoned in the Castle of Vincennes in 1695, she not only sang but wrote songs of praise to her God. "It sometimes seemed to me," she said, "as if I were a little bird whom the Lord had placed in a cage, and that I had nothing now to do but to sing. The joy of my heart gave a brightness to the objects around me. The stones of my prison looked in my eyes like rubies. I esteemed them more than all the gaudy brilliances of a vain world. My heart was full of that joy which you give to them that love you in the midst of their deepest crosses." This was her word in prison. While at the prison in Vincennes, her maid also, who was in prison with her, quickly wrote her words while she sang. The maid voluntarily followed her to prison. Madame Guyon was a heavenly store on earth, where you could come and find God living in human form. Heaven is a storehouse. Heaven can be stored. God brought it forth out of himself. We are his image and likeness. Heaven can be stored in us. The kingdom is within you. Our Lord Jesus said, Matthew chapter 6 verse 20 says, "Make storehouses for yourself in heaven." This we do by bringing heaven into our hearts. We could either bring the earth into our hearts or bring heaven into our hearts. But remember, the earth is created for footstool, heaven for the heart. The heart is a store chamber. It can house God, the one bigger than heaven. The heart we have is a magnificence, higher than everything in creation. Creation cannot house God, our hearts can. Keep your heart with all diligence. Why? Because it is the vault that carries the best treasure on earth and in heaven, the life of God in human form. So much heaven in Guyon's heart. Arguments here and there whether heaven is real. So it should not be where you are. Be the heavenly man or woman that people meet and end all arguments about the reality of heaven. God is in us, heaven is in us. Let all people everywhere see heaven in us as we live heavenly lives ourselves. For we are the storehouses of heaven on earth. Glory to our God. Amen. So much heaven in Guyon's heart. While in the notorious prison house of Bastille, France, she wrote this poem. A little bird I am, shut in from the fumes of air, and in my cage I sit and sing to him who placed me here. Well pleased a prisoner to be, because my God it pleases you. Nothing have I else to do. I sing the whole day long, and he whom most I love to please does listen to my song. He caught and bound my wandering wings, but still he bends to hear me sing. You have an ear to hear, a heart to love and bless, and though my nose were ever so rude, you would not hear the less, because you know as they fall that love, sweet love, inspires them all. My cage confine me round, abroad I cannot fly, but though my wing is closely bound, my heart is at liberty. My prison walls cannot control the flight, the freedom of the soul. Oh, it is good to soar, these boughs and bars above, to him whose purpose I adore, whose providence I love, and in your mighty will to find the joy, the freedom of the mind. Amen. What did she have to say of her many other imprisonment, totaling about 10 years in all added together? While again in prison, she wrote of her only offense that had put her in prison yet again. Love constitutes my crime, for this they keep me here. In prison tall so long a time, for him I hold so dear, and yet I am as when I came, the subject of his holy flame. Those who imprison me should know, true love can never die. Yes, tread and crush it with disdain, and it will fire and burn again. For thee they smite me and reprove, because I cannot cease to love. Eternal life shall never decay. God is the life of love, and when its source of life is over, and only then it will shine no more. Amen. Wow, this is amazing. Guyon is saying you have to defeat God to defeat love. At another point, Guyon had this to say to strengthen those who will suffer like her, all because of their love and devotion to God. Think, when oppressed with grief and cares, the time will soon draw near when you shall have a lasting house, a mansion in the sky. A mansion in the sky, dear companion in tribulation and in the patience and kingdom of the Lord Jesus Christ. Can you endure these trials and these evil times? Can you continue moving, holding on in faith and in love, till in the midst of this crisis, our lives experience the joys of heaven, and then we mirror heaven to others, knowing that very soon we will all be living in a mansion in the sky, in the new heaven and the new earth soon coming to life. Christ in us, the hope of glory. Amen. Thank you.